अब मैं निवेदन करूंगा माननीय अरुण जेटली जी से, जो भारत सरकार के वित्त मंत्री, पार्टी के वरिष्ठ नेता, कृपया इस विषय पर अपने दृष्टिकोण को आगे दें।
The Honorable Prime Minister, the Party President Shri Amit Bhai Shah, my senior colleagues in the government and the party, friends of the media. The NDA and the BJP are already a government in power, and therefore we hope to go into our second term as a continuing government. We gave to this country a manifesto in 2014. We have been a highly performing government which fulfilled that manifesto. This Sankalp Patra is one of a government which is going to continue in power, and therefore wants to expedite the path of progress of this country. This manifesto, in a season of manifestos, is not prepared with a tukade-tukade mindset. It's not even prepared with an Ivy League mindset. This has been prepared with a strong nationalist vision, and it has been prepared after a detailed consultation by a committee headed by Shri Rajnath Singh Ji across the country, and is therefore rooted in Indian realities. Those who failed in the past for decades, not for years, can manufacture fresh ideas for the future. But those who have delivered in the past have a credibility to offer a roadmap for the future. 2014 was an election in a cynical environment. There was high levels of corruption. There was policy paralysis, there was indecisiveness of leadership, and obviously there was a government which had paralyzed decision making. Our security scenario was also gloomy. Both the BJP and our prime ministerial candidate at that time, Shri Narendra Modi, held a hope. And therefore, in a cynical environment, that was an election which promised hope. Today, the environment is entirely different. We have a government which delivered. Our new security doctrine makes India into one of the most powerful nations in the world, where our deterrent itself is our best defense. Not only our three conventional forces and our paramilitary forces, our ability in cyberspace, our ability in outer space, and our new policy of striking at terror at the point of origin has received global support. This is a new security doctrine for the future. And therefore, we will reject all ideas for the balkanization of India, which many others in the political and public space promise. And we will act completely with an idea which promises to make India one of the strongest and the secure countries of the world. This is the first 5 years that India was globally the fastest growing economy in the world. Our fiscal prudence, since 1947 has been the best ever for a five-year government. Our inflation has been the lowest compared to what our predecessor government left behind, a double-digit inflation. We are the first government in history which consolidated India's middle class and which brought out the fastest depletion of poverty. Previous governments had only given slogans. Prime Minister Modi's government delivered resources to the poor. We are the only government which, for the benefit of the people, including the poor and the middle class, not only controlled inflation, but actually gave to India a five-year tenure where taxes were only reduced, never increased. This was done with the idea of putting more money in the pockets of people so that they could spend more. But we expanded our base. We expanded our collections. And we transferred our resources to infrastructure. We transferred our resources to the poor. As a continuing government, we will follow the same principle. The essence of the manifesto, whose salient points was given just now, is to deplete poverty over the next 5 years to single digit and then eventually eliminate it. Our object is to give India a world-class infrastructure. We have provided in this manifesto for 100 lakh crore investment over 5 years in infrastructure. We have provided for doubling the income of farmers, and all this will ensure 8% plus growth rate for India, which will retain our position as the world's fastest growing economy, the most exponentially growing fast middle class, which then is able to get rid of the menace of poverty in India, and a country which will continue to be regarded as a bright spot in the global economy. This is our mission as far as the next 5 years and beyond that is concerned. As I said, this manifesto lays a roadmap of a continuing government. Those who have performed, their words carry high credibility than those who failed in the past. And therefore, the most important fact is that when India is at the cusp of history, covering up for all the lost opportunities, where it has to make India a land of opportunities once again, what is the kind of government we require? Do we require a visionless government? Do we require multiple leaders taking claim for leadership? Do we require a fragile government? A failed idea 5 times experimented in the past? Or do we require a single party majority government with allies representing the federal character of India as an inbuilt part of that coalition? The 2014 to 19 experiment has shown that India cannot experiment the adventurism of failed ideas, because this is an opportunity that India cannot let go. Thank you very much, once.